First of all, Yakov, how do you keep your concentration levels so high with the defence being so good and you're maybe not called upon as often as other goalkeepers in games?
I don't know if it's just, again, go back to Stefan. just looking at what he did, there's maybe in a game you've only got one or two things to do and you need to do them. I probably talk to keep myself involved in the game when the ball's not really near me. No talk to myself, try and keep defenders right and stuff. So, and just really get into the game. So if you're like watch the game, make sure your position is right wherever the ball is. If the ball's up the other side of the park, just make sure you're doing yourself right.
Next one, Alan Douglas. What goalie did you look up to when you were coming through the ranks? Who's your time favourite Rangers player?
My two were Schmeichel and Gorham when I was growing up. Two totally different goalkeepers, but two, like, you could, the best I've ever seen. So looked up to them. And obviously fortunate enough to train with Andy when I was a young boy.
That must have been a great experience for you as well, looking up to one of your heroes. Oh,
it was, aye. I used to go in on Easter holidays and that and be able to train with them, so it was good.
Brilliant. Next one, Shoreditch Loyal. What's the best game you've ever played in and why would you say, you know, you've got many to choose from?
Probably say the last day of the season at Kilmarnock. It was a bit surreal, to be honest. 3-0 up after 7 minutes, and obviously it wasn't finished, but it was a decent start. But I think that will stick in my head.
That was a great day. Gary asks, who were your inspirations growing up? Was there certain goalies you looked up to? I know you've mentioned two earlier.
Yeah, well, just the same really. They too. Schmeichel was brilliant, massive presence, made unbelievable saves. Also, obviously the goalie did as well, but just two different types of goalkeeping.
Next one is, once a Ranger, who would be your ideal centre-back partnership from all the centre-backs you played with during your time?
I can't say that with the voice here, surely.
There's so many, isn't there?
There's a lot to choose for. I'm not going to say two because I'll get dogs abuse. So.
You'll get done in, won't you?
Can't do that.
Okay, what about what coach has been the best for you throughout your career?
The best? I think it's, honestly, I've been incredibly fortunate with coaches. Like, really, really, like, when I started, it was obviously Hodgie for a couple of years. And Billy Thompson came in, and he was brilliant for me. Honestly, like, brilliant. And then, obviously, Jim Stewart, who I worked with at Scotland 21s and that, so I knew him very well in Scotland. And then, even in Hull, Gary Walsh, Pat Mountain, Barry Richardson. Honestly, I've been very lucky throughout my career to have really good goalie coaches. So, obviously Colin now as well.
Same chap asks, can Robbie McCrory come in and replace you and can it really take your place years down the line, hopefully, for you? But can he follow in your footsteps?
Well, hopefully he can. I think, as I said, the first time I seen him in pre-season, I thought, this guy's really good. Now it's up to himself just to be consistent playing with Livingston, getting the experience. And then when he comes back, just to go and kick on again.
This guy asks, a young goalkeeper himself, do you have any advice for him to help improve and get better? He's just a youth goalie.
To improve? I think just, in that age, go for everything. Make sure you're not just standing watching the ball going in. Die for everything, because it'll be one you'll not realise you've made it yourself. It'll take you by surprise. And just keep going and going and going all the time. And don't let anything beat you. Die for everything.
Pedro asks, is the Werder Bremen save still your best, would you think?
It's probably up there, just with everything, really. When you've liked it, you go to extra time anyway, that's for sure. And we had the cup final on the Sunday, so that might have been a different outcome as well. So just different factors like that. And they managed, obviously, to get the final, so taking all that into consideration, probably.
Pedro also asks, are you one for swapping jerseys with opponents, and if you do, what's the best one you've ever swapped?
To be fair, I never thought I was, and then I've looked and I've got actually quite a few. Czechs probably must be up there, innit? It's got to be Rayner. I'm trying to think who else there is. Pallop with Seville, Van der Sar. So I didn't think I did, but I actually obviously I have at the time.
Bad list, to be fair.
Ah, it's not a bad list, aye.
Talked about the Bremen save. Is there a specific match that is a favourite of yours, whether it's a busy one or the importance of it?
Again, just probably the Kilmarnock one, last game of the season. Two stands packed, getting the three goals in the first 7 minutes, it's crazy. Crazy.
Gary Dunlop asks, any advice for trying to concentrate and dealing with the mental side of the game? Sometimes you're busy, sometimes you're not. How do you cope with that? You touched on that earlier.
Probably just to get into the game. Don't let your mind wander anywhere else. If the ball's at the park, always look to see where your players, if it breaks down, make sure they're in the right position. And always think that and try and... It's easier to tell them now because there's no fans, but
yeah.
If there's fans there, you obviously can't shout halfway at the park, but just keeping yourself right and keeping yourself focused on the game by looking at what the players are doing and if the ball breaks down, what your position is.
He also asked if you had any advice for goalies that had setbacks, maybe had an injury, like yourself, when you were a younger man,
didn't
progress any advice
to through
things like that, situations like that?
I'm trying to think, I don't know actually. It's 20 years ago now. Just get one. Well, I know it was obviously easier for me because I had physio every day. So for somebody, it's not, I don't know. I wish I could help. You obviously need to be pain free, so I'd imagine you'd need to go and see a physio on that first. And just make sure you're pain free, get better, and then see physio, and then work on your strength. That's one thing I should have done more, probably worked on my strength. It was my wrist, so I was like that, oh, I don't want to lift weights because it's sore and that, but if the muscles round about that area are strong, then it will obviously help.
Next one, William says, will you look to stay in football when you hang up? Are you interested in becoming a goalie coach at any stage?
I've been having this discussion lately. I'm not sure. I didn't at first because I seen the rigmarole you need to go through to get your badges, which put me off. But I don't know. I might enjoy it. I might something different. So I don't know. Plus, you need to do your outfield to get start your goalies for some reason. It's mental. Just add more things in just for more dough probably. So. I'm thinking about it more now, yeah.
Same guy asked, what was Stefan like to you when you were coming through the academy? How helpful was he to kind of pass on his knowledge?
He was brilliant. As again, he didn't say a lot, but what he said was good. And obviously, I was looking at him like before games and stuff. He just sat there in total focus on what he had to do. He was brilliant.
The iReady podcast asks, your favourites, your save against Werder Bremen or that penalty save against Samaras? Again, both important ones.
Aye, it's a hard one. What, a better save or the one, I don't know. Both are obviously fairly important, so both joint then, we'll say that.
I do seem to remember you enjoying the Samaras one, particularly good.
Aye.
Aye.
Well, of course you enjoy it.
I remember you died bringing your suit.
That's right, aye. That was a good day, that. They're the days, like, they're the memories you've got, isn't it?
That's right.
And you're successful, right. So.
Somebody asked, did somebody mentor you as a youngster at Ibrox? And do you do the same back now with the young goalies, or is it more about a team?
Mentor? Team it's more, I think nowadays, I think the coaching staff have got like the video training, so obviously they go over that with the young boys. I've obviously never had that, so I think it's probably easier now when you can give them more information. Maybe too much information at times, but every little thing they do in the training gets cameraed and they can videoed, so they can go over that with the coaches.
Is there anything different from young goalkeepers progressing now and coming through the ranks nowadays to when you broke through? Is that a different game at all? Or?
I suppose the rules have changed a bit, aye. I remember I started playing, you could pass the ball back.
I wasn't going to say that.
Aye, so I said it for you, aye. Has it changed? Well, it's probably changed. I think the ball moves fast, I think the game's quicker. I think teams like to play it for the back a lot more now, so you need to be comfortable doing that. So, all in all, I think it's changed a bit.
Yeah.
I definitely think you need to be better with the ball at your feet nowadays.
I was going to say that. You look at the goalies down south, guys like Alisson and Ederson, their passes are almost like assists now, aren't they? They're just smacking it.
No, very good. But I still, again, I'm a bit of an old school, but I'd still rather somebody that stops the ball going in rather than somebody can play an 8-yard pass at somebody's feet, but that's just me.
CFP Lyle says, do you think playing in England improved your game, and if so, in what ways?
I wouldn't say it improved my game that much, no. And it was it being disrespectful, but I think it's fairly obvious against better players every week. Did that help? Maybe it did. But I suppose it's just like playing in Europe to a certain extent. I don't know if it made me any better in any other way. I don't know. I'm not sure about that, actually. I don't think so.
Stuart asks, were you concerned about maybe the fans' reaction when you came back? He says in brackets, I speak on behalf of every Rangers fan that I'm so glad that you did. Did that ever cross your mind what the reaction might be?
No, not really. I wanted to, obviously, wanted to come back, and as soon as I heard the club wanted me back, I was coming. So I didn't really think about. I think I know myself. I done the right thing for the club. No me.
Yep.
I could have easily stayed. I know I'll maybe come out in a few years if I do a book or something. But I know, and I can. Yeah. Oh my hell, I done the best for the club. No myself. I wasn't thinking about myself, so.
Somebody's asking, why did you used to shout at Sasa Papach so much? To be fair, it's not just Sasa.
No, it's not just Sasa, aye. He maybe got a brunt it a couple of times, but you just need to do what you do in the pitch. You need to tell people. People would react differently nowadays as well, so I need to sort of watch what I'm doing as well. But it's just passion, that's what it is.
Yeah.
I'm wrong with that, I don't think.
Well, definitely not.
I suppose if it's in the right way, which I need to learn.
Kind of the right way, of course. Do you want to go back to that favourite player one? Is that too?
Oh, that played way, innit? Or favourite player or best?
The best player you played with.
Don't know.
You, Alan.
Sure, no. Okay, two.
Maybe pick a handful, maybe pick a few.
Right. Obviously, the two De Boers, Mikey Caniggia was there. Fergie's unbelievable midfielder, one of the best. You've got Newman, you've got players that have played in World Cups. Caniggia, they say to him, didn't they? Mikey Moles, Dado. Like, the list you could go on and on and on and on.
Well, that's a great career then, if you've
got
names like that coming out, isn't it?
Ah, it's not bad,
aye. Last one, you moved to Turkey. How was that experience for you? How did you enjoy playing there or not?
It was different. It was good though, it was enjoyable. The city was good. I suppose if you look back, it was good you've sort of done it, played abroad, but it was a good experience. It was only a year anyway, so.
Yeah. Definitely the last one. 4 or 5 people have asked this. It's a kind of similar theme. What advice do you have for young goalies kind of trying to progress in the game, whether it's the highest level or just making a career for themselves?
It's just never giving up. You might have, we've all had bad times and good times, but never to give up. Always try and better yourself. Always keep going. Always keep diving and trying, getting, saving something that you think you'll never get to. Just keep going.
And you've had plenty of good memories as a result for the hard work you've put in, haven't you?
Yeah, one or two, aye. One or two.